the most beautiful place in the world, where a Tar Heel blue sky blankets Murphy on its way to the Tennessee border. It's a long way from Raleigh and the Outer Banks, but we're living in Carolina too. In fact, you might call it extreme Carolina. With more, here's Michael Borkman.
Welcome everyone to Extreme Carolina, a show that focuses on great people with great stories who prove in their everyday lives that anything is possible. We strive to bring you relatable life lessons from interesting and inspiring people as they live out their purpose on this earth. And today, we are truly blessed to have in the studio with us today someone that has an amazing background, and I just want to introduce her to everyone. And her name is Elder Thelena Blount Turner, and she is also one of the ministers here locally in Murphy. But before I get to that, she has spent 4 years with the North Carolina Employment Security Commission, 18 years with the United States Department of Agriculture and Forest Service contract specialist, 2 years as a financial aid specialist, Hocking College. I know everybody know where that's at, in Nelsonville, Ohio. From 2011 to present, she's one of the three associate pastors at Mount Zion Missionary Baptist Church in Murphy, North Carolina. Welcome, Elder Thelena.
Good morning and thank you.
Well, it is our pleasure. We're glad you're here. If the folks know how long I've been trying to get your husband here, you know, had I known, all I had to do was talk to you. I would have been at him here a long time ago. I guarantee you it's been well over a year. I'm busy, this going on, that going on. Our mutual friend, Zula, she said, Elder Turner busy. I can't get him. He's in Tennessee. He's in Alabama. He's all over the place. But anyway, we're glad you're here today.
Thank you.
And today we're going to talk about not just you, but we're going to talk about his turn ministry, The Clarion Call, Equipping the Saints for Spiritual Warfare.
Yes.
Now, this is a program that's coming up here on August 9th and 10th.
Correct.
And that'll be a program that is hosted by you.
By me.
And so can you tell us just a little bit about this particular program?
This particular ministry initially began just to help and to talk to people that had been hurt and abused predominantly. And then it increased and went on to include men and women, and it kept growing for the need to minister to those that were invisible, that were not being seen and not being heard by a lot of us out there, just being passed over.
Mm-hmm. And a lot of the times when we have had this particular thing happen to us, whether it be men or women, it's something we are not readily want to talk about.
Correct.
And so it's kind of pushed down inside of us instead of being dealt with.
Correct.
But this ministry and your background are equipped to handle this and to work with those folks. Hence, the title of this particular thing, The Clarion Call, Equipping. So this is helping the folks to deal with that hurt.
To deal with the hurt and to accept and recognize that we have tools, that God-given tools that help us to deal with those things that are unspoken and unresolved.
Amen to that. Wow, that is great. So this 2 days, people will be able to come out and hear not only from you, but from some other speakers that will be on the program with you.
Yes.
And I actually got the flyer here in front of me. But let's just get that out there right now so folks will know. If they wanted to find out more information, there is a website and phone number, stuff like that they can find out about.
There is a website, His Turn Ministry. At gmail.com, and that's all one word.
Okay. Well, that's fine. And we'll also, while we're doing that, we got some support in this radio station. as we always do. But we want people to be able to find it and to show up, because they're going to hear this program and they're going to want to know when, you know, what time and all of that stuff. So we're going to let them know that today. So do you know what time it starts?
It will start at 10 o'clock on Friday
morning,
August the 9th.
Mm-hmm.
And again, at 10 o'clock on Saturday. It will be held at 10 Texana Community Road at Texana Community Center in Murphy.
Okay. All right. And so, and the website and the email, one more time, give it to us, please.
The website is histurnministry.com.
Okay. Got it. Okay. And if anyone wanted to email and get some information.
If you wanted to email me, it's histurnministry@gmail.com.
Awesome. Fantastic. We'll say that again before we end the show. But we want to get more into. Now, what? Why have you done one of these before? Is this the first one, the inaugural program? First
this
time?
This is the inaugural, the kickoff program as far as the conference. Okay. I've done the His Turn Ministry and 12-week sessions of that several times, at least twice since I've been in Murphy, and then every 12 weeks in Atlanta when I lived in Stone Mountain.
Okay. So this is not a first-time thing for you. You've done this before just in other areas.
Right, correct.
And so what's making it be different this time from when you did in Stone Mountain? Or is it the same thing?
It isn't the same thing, because this is my hometown and my people.
Okay.
Western North Carolina, Eastern Tennessee, North Georgia, these are my people. And so the Lord has sent me back to minister to my people.
All right. Here in Murphy, North Carolina, which is Western North Carolina,
correct,
which is also extreme North Carolina, which is you can't get any further. As far as you can get, you get any further, you're going to be in Tennessee.
Right.
And which is why we named the show that. It's a, I wouldn't call it coincidence, but divine intervention. But the show is called Extreme Carolina, because we were looking at that. You know, when we started it, we were like, well, what can we name it? What can we name the show? Even though we were in Hayesville, mm-hmm, when we were thinking this up. And somebody said, well, why don't you just call it Extreme Carolina? You know, and I'm like, that's crazy. That don't even sound right. And then somebody pulled a map up, and we looked at the map, and it is extreme. We're sitting in extreme Western North Carolina, and it made sense, and so we went with that. But anyway, so getting back to the clarion call, and this is not just something you picked out of the sky. This has meaning to it, and the clarion itself. That's a call.
The clarion itself is a call. Usually in the scripture, it was mentioned 72 times, and it was either by a trumpet or a shofar, which is a ram's horn. And it was sounded to warn people, to alert people, and tell them it's time to get up and to move into action.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's what has a lot of meaning to me now.
Awesome. The clarion call. And we want to thank everyone for stopping on the dial today here on 95.1 FM at the Extreme Carolina Show. Today we have with us in the studio, and it is amazing that we have this lady, and she's in a background. If you could just read it. I'm not going to read it all off to everyone, but it is amazing, and it's worth checking out at least the website, if nothing else. If you can't make the program, find the website. Check it out. But Elder Turner is an amazing, amazing lady within her own right. She has done and had a lot of history. And she wasn't always in this good, positive mode that she's in now. We're going to talk about that when we come back. I want to get a little bit into your background about how you actually got started. But you've been on this trail, on this ministry run for quite a while, but it took you quite a while to get there before you recognize it. And we were talking off the air, and you were saying how people would come up to you, and they would just pour their heart, their guts out to you about their life. And it would happen time and time and time again, and you couldn't figure out, why are they doing this?
even as a child, it was just different. Like I say, definitely I started noticing at the age of 13 that people would send for me if they were sick, or call me the family would call if they were dying, had a family member dying, or to talk. But yeah, this has been something that I've been running from.
Okay. Well, I tell you what, we're going to come up on, well, we have come up on a break for our sponsors. We like to step aside and give those sponsors an opportunity to say and do what they do so that the station could stay running and open and give us an opportunity to do what we do. So don't anybody go away. We're going to be back with this amazing lady, Elder Thelena Turner, and talk a little bit about her background a little bit more, as well as the Clarion Call. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
Tar Heel Basketball, Cam's Panthers, Asheville's eclectic nightlife, and the Great Smoky Mountains. It belongs to us, too, out here in Extreme Carolina. Once again, here's Michael Borkman.
Welcome back, everyone. Welcome back. We're here excited today. We have with us in the studio Elder Thelena Turner of the Mount Zion Baptist Church in Murphy, North Carolina. And we've been talking about the Clarion's Call. But before we went away, we were talking about Elder Turner's background and how this has been happening to you pretty much your entire life, that folks would come and unburden themselves on you.
Yes.
And, I mean, for as far back as you can remember.
Yes.
And when did that ever, like, freak you out or anything? I mean, especially people you didn't know.
I grew up feeling like I was really strange. It started at 13, around the age of 13, and I thought, I'm so different that I feel different, and I don't know what this is, but it scares me. Wow. And so from 13 years old, people would come up, and they would just, strangers in the grocery store, or out playing, or in a movie, wherever, and they would start pouring out their hurt and their souls and whatever was going on. And so I started to run from it because it was just overwhelming.
I bet that was. And you ran for many, many years.
Oh, a long time. 30 years.
And you stopped running. When you stopped running, can you remember why you stopped running? You know, what to say? You know what? Man, I ain't no sense in running. I can't get away.
Because I kept shutting the voice down, the voice of the Lord speaking to me of what he wanted me to do. And I said, I'm not hearing him. And I ran and I ran until I ran into cancer. And cancer, the first time, laid me down. And I pretended that I didn't have it. And so after that, 7 years later, I had it again. And I said, I hear you this time. I hear and I know what you want to do.
Had to lay you on your back.
Had to lay me twice.
Get your attention.
Denial is a bad thing. It's not just a river.
It is a bad thing.
It is a bad thing.
Oh, my goodness. So finally, you heard the call.
Right.
And you said, okay, Lord, I'm with you. Mm-hmm. Just tell me what I got to do. Show me what I need to do. And from that moment to this one.
To this one.
You've been on the road doing God's work.
Been trying. Yes.
Amen to that, sister. Well, that's great. You know, a lot of folks. And now you understand why those folks have been coming to you. And you've been giving them each a word. And that word sometimes is powerful for that person. And it just, I'm sure a lot of times that's just overwhelming, not just for you, but for them, for the answers that you get, which are not yours.
Which are not mine.
You know, it's a God thing through you.
That's right.
And that's amazing. I would have ran to.
You know, sometimes he tells you things that you really don't want to know, but you have to let him know that it's him speaking through me. So it would sometimes knock me off my feet also. So.
Amazing. Truly amazing. Well, thank you for sharing that with us, Elder Turner. We also, on this show, we try to relate back, and that is about as basic a relating humanistic as you can get. Because we try to say, well, you know, now I feel bad. These little piddly questions that I normally ask, you know, it's like, what book have you read recently? We know yours is strongly the Bible, as well as Joyce Myers and some other people. Right. You read them a lot.
Yes.
But now, here's a question we also ask is, the best advice you've ever received, And we like to ask each guest that. So I'm going to ask you that, Elder Turner. What's the best advice you ever received?
The best advice came from a friend that once told me that in order for me to continue into my divine purpose, I had to forgive the people that had hurt me. I had to ask forgiveness from the people that I've hurt. And then I had to forgive myself. And so she also told me that unless I did that, hurt people will continue to hurt people.
Mm. And then a lot of folks say, I don't even know why I did that. Mm. And they keep doing it.
And they keep doing it.
Because they haven't forgiven themselves. First, you got to forgive those that you have hurt. Mm-hmm. And then you have to forgive yourself in order to be able to move forward with your life. Mm-hmm. That is some powerful. I like that. I mean, it's a good thing this is being recorded. I'll play it back and listen to it again. So, but anyway, thank you for sharing that. We appreciate that. And we also like to get into but, you know, there's been times in all of our lives that we've had setbacks. And we've got setback after setbacks after setbacks. But success, the best success, is often found in failures because we fail more than we succeed. Mm-hmm. So a time, can you share just a brief time in your life that you had a setback or a failure that propelled you forward?
Well, I think having the cancer twice, having that twice, and losing my son at he was 40. And before that, I knew that I was going to lose him early because I had been told, but I didn't want to believe that I had heard that. But that made me want to go on even more. Instead of having to shut down, I had to accept who I am in Christ and what he wanted me to do. And that was hard. I had to go through some falls. I tripped myself up, but I had to continue. Mm-hmm. Every time I fell, I had to know that it was the Lord that was lifting me up, and that was a purpose in that, that I could help lift somebody else and encourage somebody else.
Wow. That's amazing.
No testimony.
That's so true. That is so true. And all of us have a testimony. We just don't share it because we've all had tests. We've all had tests. And that test is how you come through, how you handle it. Mm-hmm. And do you pick yourself back up or just lay on the floor and waddle? Oh, I'm never going to have this. I'm never going to do that. You know, mm-hmm. I'm just a terrible person. We're speaking what's happening to
us. Right.
And we talked about that off the air, and that's amazing. The voice, the tongue.
The tongue.
It's power,
death, and life is in that tongue, and we have to realize what we speak over ourselves.
Mm.
We curse out of the same mouth, and then we expect to have blessings.
That's strong. That's strong. You know, when you said that, that reminded me of somebody. Somebody said to someone else, and they were doing this cursing tirade, and they said to them, "And you kiss your mama with that same mouth?" You know, and so, you know, it happens that this coming out of our mouth, we determine where we are or where we're going to go. But we don't. And it's right there in front of us. It's not a mystery that we never find out about. It's laid out right in front of us.
Right in front of us.
Maybe some of us probably figure, man, maybe it should have been hidden. Maybe I'd have found it easier. but it's right in front of us. But anyway, thank you for sharing that. That's really amazing that, you know, that is eye-opening. And hopefully the people that are listening to the show today will get eye-opening. As a matter of fact, let's give them another opportunity to find how they can get 2 days of this. Because you told me, or was it Brother Turner that said it's 2 days?
2 days.
Limited seating.
Limited seating, limited space available. There's no registration fee. It's the Clarion Call, Equipping the Saints for Spiritual Warfare, held at 10 Texana Community Center Road at the Community Center on August the 9th and the 10th.
Awesome. And if anybody wanted to go to the website ahead of time, the website is
HisTurnMinistry.com.
There you go. And she has her assistant who is answering emails. If anybody wanted to email them, then you can email them at
HisTurnMinistry@gmail.com.
All right. Now y'all heard it. There it is. And don't miss it, because this is going to be one amazing, amazing event right in Little Beatty, Murphy, North Carolina, or in Texana. To be more specific, which is
the community.
Mm-hmm. And so we'll be excited. So we want to thank you for coming on the show today and having the opportunity to share with us what is bound to be amazing and powerful.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming on the show. Once again, if I knew this what it took to get Elder Turner here, I'd talk to his wife. Still ain't had him, but still, you know, we see him. So anyway, we got to get out of here. Thanks for coming. We appreciate you. And as always, we like to thank our listeners. So I want to say thank you to you first. And both the Turners are here. Ultimately, Extreme Carolina is committed to you, our listeners, to bring you leaders and newsmakers that are passionate and purpose-driven, like Elder Turner here today. By listening to their stories, Extreme Carolina listeners will have an opportunity to refuel, reconnect, and get inspired by unlocking the power of the people. And don't miss this clarion call. It's going to be amazing. So the quote of the week is really, really simple and real basic. Some succeed because they are destined to, but most succeed because they are determined to. Awesome. We got to get out of here, folks. Thank everybody for listening in, tuning in. We'll see y'all next time. God bless. Peace. We out.